Hi guys, welcome to another video. If you're new here, my name is Wendy, and in this channel I share everything related to my experience with chronic kidney disease, dialysis, and kidney transplant. If you're on a similar path, this channel can give you an insight as to what to expect, prevent common mistakes, and hopefully improve your overall wellness. I invite you to come with me on this journey as I move along with my second chance at life, so make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. In today's video, I'm going to share with you 7 tips that helped me tons when I was on peritoneal dialysis, and I'm pretty sure they will help you too. Tip number 1 is acceptance. This might not apply to all of you, but it does for a lot of people. Trust me, hearing a doctor saying that I won't make it 6 months unless I start emergency dialysis were some of the most difficult words I had ever heard in my life. It can be incredibly difficult to get out of a state of fear, anger, and sadness, you know, knowing that life has taken such a drastic turn. And although these are very acceptable feelings to have, in the long run, it's not going to serve you. Without working kidneys, the body is fighting for survival every day. The best thing you can do is to make a conscious decision to be positive, to follow your diet, to avoid stress, to have fun, and to try to be happy. Accepting is to let the unchangeable be and focus on what can be done, and that is to keep ourselves as healthy as possible. Your body will respond to your state of mind, so choose your thoughts and your feelings carefully. Tip number 2, create a daily routine. Make a daily schedule and stick to it. Having a consistent routine, at least for eating dinner and connecting, is going to help you tons. Having an empty stomach will make you feel more comfortable while doing your treatment. For me, starting a routine where I had dinner by 5 p.m. and connected by 9 p.m. made a huge difference on how comfortable I felt with the liquid in me. You know your body better, but in general, the emptier your stomach is, the more comfortable you will be. And that brings me to my next tip. Tip number 3 is to avoid constipation. Constipation is dangerous because it can cause peritonitis. It is also uncomfortable and not only will make your stomach feel super full, it can also cause your machine to wake you up at night with warnings saying that it's not able to drain or that it's draining slowly. Something that you can do to fix this is to change positions or just move around. To avoid constipation, I prefer natural ways as opposed to laxatives. Something that helped me a lot was to have a bowl of oatmeal with plenty of chia seeds and a quarter of banana for breakfast, and also walking right after dinner. But being honest, on other times, laxatives are absolutely necessary. If there is something that has worked for you to avoid constipation, feel free to share in the comments below. Tip number 4 is catheter maintenance. Clean your exit site every day. This is probably the most important tip I can give you. An infection is the most common complication among PD patients. Follow the steps your clinic gives you for connecting. Some things might feel unnecessary, but trust me, they are important. Also, clean your exit site every day. I know this can be tiring to do every day, but it's better than to deal with peritonitis. I was very thorough with my cleanings, and thankfully in the 9 months that I did dialysis, I never had an infection. I recommend to set an alarm or just, like I say, create a routine. I always clean my exit site right before I start connecting. Number 5 is do not miss your treatments if you can help it. Dialysis can sometimes feel like work, and just like work, you can feel like taking a day off from time to time, but unless it's absolutely necessary, try not to. When we go into kidney failure, it's because the kidneys can no longer do the work that is necessary for us to continue functioning. Even though dialysis is helping with that, what dialysis does for us will never be as effective as a working kidney. So if on top of that, we skip our treatments, our body is really going to feel it. I noticed the times I took off, I just didn't feel well the following days. It really made me realize that spending 20 minutes connecting, even if I was tired, was better than to deal with 3 days of not feeling good. Tip number 6 is eliminate noise and light for a better night's sleep. So not being constipated or full are already going to increase your chances to get a better night's sleep. But something that put the cherry on top for me was eliminating noises and light in my room. The screen of the cycler is very bright, even in the lower settings, and the machine makes tons of noises, especially during the exchanges. So what I did was to cover the screen with a piece of cardboard or a mat, and that make my room pitch black. I also got some amazing earplugs, and I will make sure to leave you guys the link in the description, because not all the earplugs work the same, and these ones were amazing. So those two things combined took me from sleeping 2 hours at a time to 6 hours straight. When you can sleeping 6 hours straight is amazing. And lastly, make connecting fun. You might think there is nothing fun about connecting to a machine, but it can be if you make it. Connecting took me about 25 minutes every night. It was the time of the day when I closed my door and I was by myself, so I decided to associate something positive with that time. I played music, I sung, I listened to comedy, I asked Alexa to tell me jokes. She got really some of the worst jokes ever.
One time, I dug up a potato joke, but it was a little too dirty. Yuck!
Today, I don't remember my connecting time as something traumatizing or boring. You know, definitely not something that I will want to do it again, but while it happened, I can say that I made the best of it. So as an extra tip or note, if you ever experience shoulder pain, check out this video, because in this video, I share with you guys how to fix it and how to get rid of it. Well, that's all I have for today, guys. Remember that although we don't have much control over our disease, we do have control over our attitude towards it. Don't allow a disease to take away your smile. Have an amazing day, and I'll see you guys very soon.